Well, I won't back down. No, I won't back down. You can stand me up at the gates of hell, but I won't back down. Gonna stand my ground, won't be turned around. And I'll keep this world from dragging me down. Gonna stand my ground, and I won't back down. Hey, baby, there ain't no easy way out.
The name of the Congress, Medal of Honor, Specialist for Gary G. Wetzel, United States Army, for conspicuous gallantry and intrepidity in action at the risk of his life above and beyond the call of duty. Specialist for Gary G. Wetzel, 173rd Assault Helicopter Company, distinguished himself near Ap Dong An in the Republic of Vietnam. On January 8, 1968, Specialist Wetzel was serving as a door gunner aboard a helicopter which was part of an insertion force trapped in the landing zone by intense and deadly hostile fires. He was going to the aid of his aircraft commander when he was blown into a rice paddy and critically wounded. Although bleeding profusely due to severe wounds, he staggered back to his original position and took the enemy forces under fire. His machine gun was the only weapon placing effective fire on the enemy at that time. Specialist Wetzel remained at his position until he had eliminated the automatic weapons emplacement that had been inflicting heavy casualties on the American troops. Refusing to attend to his own extensive wounds, he attempted to return to the aid of his aircraft commander, but passed out from loss of blood. Regaining consciousness, he persisted in his efforts to drag himself to the aid of his fellow crewmen. Specialist Wetzel displayed extraordinary heroism at the risk of his own life. His gallant actions were in keeping with the highest traditions of the United States Army and reflect great credit upon himself and the armed forces of his country.
You can stand me up at the gates of hell, but I won't back down. Gonna stand my ground, won't be turned around. And I'll keep this world from dragging me down. Gonna stand my ground.
Memorial Day, we remember the men and women who have served our great nation, and also the men and women who have given the ultimate sacrifice. I often think of my buddy who died my arm. My aircraft commander was Timothy Artment from Florida, and he had plans of being a commercial pilot. Timmy was kind of a tall, lanky guy, good-natured, good sense of humor, and he wasn't only my pilot, but he was also my friend. On the day of the incident, we're coming into what they refer to as a hot LZ, about treetop level. That's when we got nailed. The crossfire was so horrendous on both sides of the ship. Him and I got shot down. I know Timmy's hurt up front. I gotta jump out of the ship and see how I can help him. That's when there's a big explosion. He kept telling us, tell Jane he loves her, which is his wife. And I'm like, shut up. Tell your own wife you love her, we'll get out of this mess. I got him in my arm right here, and he looked at me and told Jane, and then he died. War is hellish. It's nothing to brag about. I remember I took what was left of my arm and kind of tucked it inside my pants so it wouldn't flop. And we had one medic that I found out that was alive on a little higher ground, so I'd kind of like skid the guys over by him so he could patch these guys up. Yeah, I did that throughout the evening, and I just chose to give it my best and do the best that I could.
The President of the United States of America has awarded in the name of the Congress the Medal of Honor to Specialist 4 Gary G. Wetzel.
And when I had the privilege to wear that blue ribbon, you know, I wear it for everybody, so it's part of all of us. It's personal. On Memorial Day, because we have certain friends that have given the ultimate sacrifice. I head down to Washington, D.C., what we refer to as Rolling Thunder. My bike is any different than anybody else's. I helped redesign my arm so I could pull my clutch in and out and ride that bike. And it's my independence. You know, you sit on that iron horse, thousands of people waving, yelling, screaming. Here it's 49 years later. I go down to the wall, his name's there, 27E, line 80, that's where he's at. I gotta say what I gotta say to him because I have to. And it's out of respect and love for Timmy that I do that. So that's what I do. We use that word freedom, but people don't realize that there's a price that's paid for it. Those men and women on that wall put the same concept and same beliefs and ideas that our forefathers did. We put our heart and soul into that flag for what it stands for. Look into that flag. Look into that flag and think about the sacrifices men and women have given you and I to be here. That's what it's all about.